Welcome back, friends. In the last video, we have implemented how to implement unit test cases for control layer, unit test cases for REST API. Okay, we have written some test cases for our REST API cloud operation. In our inventory application, there is a three layer: controller layer, product service layer, and a DAO layer. We have completed the implementing the controller layer. Okay, now in this video, we're going to cover how to write a unit test cases for product manager service layer without depending on DAO layer. Okay, I have implemented already. So this is a product manager service. Here we have a five methods: save method, get method, and get all method, and delete product. We have a 1, 2, 3, 4 methods. For these four method, we need to write a unit test cases. Okay, when we do the JUnit test cases, we don't have to connect with database. Because we need to test our only the logic implemented in the service method. For example, in the save method, we have implemented some logic here by taking price and tax. By taking price, we are finding a tax and the total. Then we are setting the tax price and total price. We want to verify that this particular logic working perfectly. There is no pointing to saving the data to the database while testing this logic. Our intention is we want to test only this logic. We don't have to care about the DB connection, DB storing the data to the database. For that, we're going to do separate JUnit test cases. Okay. Okay. Now we're going to see this class. If you want to write a JUnit using Marketo framework, we need to annotate the particular class at extend with annotation. This annotation available for only JUnit 5. This annotation only for JUnit 5, not previous version, older version. Older version is different thing. For example, here, if you are using JUnit version lesser than 5, we have to use run with at run with annotation by passing spring nano.class or market to JUnit nano.class. This thing we need to use in the case of before JUnit 5. If you are using greater than JUnit 5 or equal to JUnit 5, we need to use extend with. We have to pass Marketo extension. We have to pass Marketo extension dot class. Okay. Then, now this is product manager service test. So my JUnit class. Using this class, I want to test product manager service. Okay. I want to test product manager service. Whatever class you want to test, that class must be annotated with at inject mark. My intention is I want to test product manager service, so we need to define that product manager service using at inject mock annotation. Using this annotation, we are telling to Marketo framework, hey, I want to test product manager service. Then whatever classes defined inside a product manager service, whatever classes defined inside a product manager service, those classes we need to mock. For example, in our case, in the product manager service, we have defined one class called product repository interface. Okay, this product repository class is a very important class. It's a dependent class of product manager's service. So without product repository class, we cannot test any method, because in all method we are using this product repository class, right? We are using product repository. In the case of serve method, we are calling serve method from product repository. So we have to mock this particular class. How to mock? We can use mock annotation. Here I am saying using this mock annotation, I am saying to the Marketo framework, I want to mock this object which used by product manager service. Meaning of this annotation is at inject mocks, I want to test product manager service. Using meaning of this particular annotation, this particular class defined inside a product manager service. I want to mark this particular object. Okay, I don't want to call any method inside a product repository class. Okay, in the save product, in the implementation method, in the save product, I am populating the product object. I am populating the product object. Then, using this line, I am providing some instruction to Marketo framework. Whenever called save method from product repository, please don't call database, don't call real method. That meaning, don't call this real method that defined in the crude repository class. When you go to product repository, it is extended from JPA repository. Okay, the serve method defined in crude repository. Okay, crude repository is a parent class of JPA repository. When you take a look here, JPA repository extended from pagination and a sorting repository. Again, this is extended from crude repository. This crude repository contains the serve method. Okay, we are calling that method only here. I am saying to the Marketo framework, don't call that method. I am saying to Marketo framework, don't call this method. Whenever call save method from product repository, please don't call that. Instead of that, return this product which I populating here. Return this product object which I populating here. Whenever call save method from the product manager service. When I look at the product manager service save, I am calling this method, right? I am calling this save method from product repository. When call that save method from product repository via product manager service, don't call the save real method. Instead of that, return product object which I populating here. That is the meaning of this line. Okay, the next line I am calling product manager dot save. As I give an instruction here, according to this instruction, whenever call product manager dot save, it never called the save method. Instead of, it will return the product object, that product object assigned to here. Okay, what will happen here? Whenever call this product manager service, this product object passed here, it will take a tax and a total and calculating a tax and calculating total and assigning total to the product, assigning tax to the tax. Then that particular product object returned here without connecting DB. Then here I am checking get tax. Here product price I mentioned 300, right? And in the logic we have mentioned tax is a 10%. That meaning for 300 tax is a 30. Tax is a 30, right? I am checking here asset equals 30. The tax is a 30 or not. Then after adding price and a tax, total is a 330 will come. Then I am checking here, total price is 330. Before doing this check, I am asserting that the new product is null or not. If it is not null, it will come and check these two conditions. If it is null, the test case will fail here. Okay. Before doing this, just I am printing that value here. I hope you understand how this method is working. This method never call product repository save method. Instead, it return the product object when you call the save method from the product manager service. Okay. Now we're going to start testing. Test case is pass. See 30 and 330 printing. Test case is pass. If you change 30 to 31, test case is fail. So test case is failed now. I'll change back to 30. So whenever test your business logic, whenever test your business logic, we don't have to connect external server. The external server anything, right? In our case, a database, or in some scenario, we need to connect an email server. We need to connect some FTP server. We need to connect some server. Okay, we don't have to connect those external service. Okay, we don't have to connect those external service while testing your business logic. While testing your business logic, okay, we can bypass that by using a Marketo framework. If you're not using Marketo framework, what will happen? You need to write some mock object. For that, you need to write a bunch of code. You need to spend a lot of time to write a mock object. It will consume a lot of time. Okay, Marketo framework saving our time. It makes developer life very easy. We don't have to write any mock object. Just we have to provide some information to the Marketo framework. According to that information, your Marketo framework will work. Here I am saying, whenever call save method from product manager service, don't call real save method from product repository. Just return product object, which I am constructing here. That's it. So whenever call the save method, it never call the save method. Instead of that, that will return this product object here. Also, it will execute this business logic. Execute this business logic. All the data get populated here. Then that data I am asserting here. That's it. The same way we need to write a test cases in your project. Okay. Here, get product by ID. There is another method I want to check, get product by ID from the product manager service. Okay. This get product by ID calling find by ID method from the product repository. This find by ID return optional object, optional of product. See here, optional of product object, this will return. Okay. From the optional container object, I am calling one method called get method. That get method return a product object. Okay, return a product object. Now I want to test this method. While testing, I don't want to call this real find by ID, which is coming from product repository. So first I'm populating the product object. Then I'm passing this product object inside an optional container object, by using this line. Optional product option is a variable equal to optional of, I'm passing this product. That meaning you are passing this product inside an optional object. Then whenever call find by ID from the product repository, I'm saying whenever call find by ID from the product repository, don't call real find by ID. Don't connect database. Don't call real find by ID. Instead of that, just return product optional object, which I created here. According to this instruction, while calling get product by ID from the product manager service, this method return this particular optional object here. Okay. So when you look at this method, whenever call this method in our test cases, what will happen? Whatever object I constructed here, that object will come. That object returned here. That object returned by this find by ID. From that optional object, I am calling get method, get return product object. That product object I am assigning here. Then here I am checking the product is null or not. If it is null, the test case is failed. If it is not null, this part gets success. Okay. After that, I am checking one element from the product object, get name. If get name equal to Apple, then I am considering this test case is a pass because I am setting here Apple. That same value I am expecting. Here also. Okay. So very similarly, get all products also. Okay. First, I am going to creating a two product object. This two product object I am adding to array list because get all products return array of products. When you look at here, get all products return array of product. Get all product calling product repository dot find all. This find all return array of product. For example, if you have a 10 rows in your database, the 10 row return in the form of list object. Okay, but in my unit test cases, I don't want to call real find all method. I don't want to connect to database. Instead of that, I want to return some mock object. Mock of product object. So that only I am constructing product list here. then I'm giving the instruction to Markita framework, whenever call find all method from product repository, don't call real method. Instead of that, just return this array list, just return this array list which I constructed here. Okay, now I'm calling get all products from the product manager service. According to this instruction, this method return product list, this method return product list which I constructed here. Here I am checking, assert that I am passing this new product list is not null. That should not be a null, and that should not be empty, and the size must be 2, because I am passing only 2. I am passing only 2. If these three conditions satisfied, this test case, this line get passed. After that, I am checking index of 0, 0th element. Zeroth element name attribute contain apple. If it is apple, I am passing this particular line. Then all product price must be greater than 200. Here I have two product. I am expecting, assert that new product list all match product dot get price greater than 200. Here I am saying 400, 300. So product price is greater than 200 only. So this line also passed. So the three conditions pass, so the entire test case is pass. Okay, the final method is delete by id. Okay, when you look at delete product by id method from service class, here I'm calling product repository dot delete by id. This delete by id accepting a long parameter which is a product id. When you pass product id, it will return that corresponding product record from the database. That is the responsibility of delete by id. Okay, but it will never return any value. It won't return any value. It's a void method. It's just a delete record and doesn't return any value. Whatever test cases we have written previously, all the method returns some value. Here it's returning product, here also returning product, here returning array of product, but here returns void method. Now we need to test this method. How to test this? Here I am calling product manager service dot delete product by id. Delete product by id. I am calling here. Already the product repository we marked, right? We marked. Already this product repository we marked using at mark annotation. Okay. In Markita framework, we have one method called verify method. Using verify method, we need to pass the marked object as the first parameter. Second parameter, we need to evaluate that. How many times the particular method executed from the service class. Here verify product repositories or marked object. Then second parameter, I am calling the times static method. Instead times static method, I am passing 1 dot delete by id, which is coming from product repository. I am saying to the Markita framework, this particular method should execute at least once while calling delete product by id, delete product by id from the product manager service. This meaning of this particular line is, whenever call delete by id from the product repository interface, I want to make sure that it execute only one time. It execute at least one time. So if you execute this delete by id one time while calling delete product by id, what will happen? This method connect to database and delete the respective product from the DB, right, in the real time. But in the testing time, we just make sure that it's calling only one time, because it's never connected to database. But we have to make sure that this method is executing while calling this method through the Markita framework. So also this should execute only one time. You should not execute two times or three times. That is the condition. Okay, if this method execute only one time while calling delete product by id, that meaning this method should work perfectly. That meaning this test case is passed. Okay, let me check now. Yeah, test case is passed because we are evaluating this delete by id should exist at least one time while calling delete product by id from the product manager service. Now I'm going to check two. this time it will get failure because I am calling this method one time inside a delete product by ID. But here I am checking two times. It's failed. Now I'll go to change here. I'll go to the service method. I'll going to call two times. Now here I pass two, right? So this time this test case should pass. Now this test case is passed because I am calling two times this particular delete by ID. That's the reason it's passing. Because I'm evaluating with two, right? Let's change back to one and remove it. One. That's it. I hope you understand all the methods, how the Mockito framework is working. Okay. If you have any question, please comment out. Definitely I will reply back. In the next session, we're going to see how to test DAO layer, how to test the DAO layer. Okay. Until then, bye bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.